I'm here at the world famous Fortune Gym in Los Angeles. Right near me is Macca Foley, the one and only. Macca, who's here today?
Well, we got a couple kids sparring in the ring. One's a chiropractor, one's just a regular kid.
Okay, you have Justin Fortune in the house.
Yeah, Fortune just got back from New York.
He was on HBO.
Eating that Italian food in New York, he gained a couple pounds.
Hanging out with ugly broads.
But watch it now.
And who else is here? We have the MMA trainer.
Vito Gasparian's here.
Where's Vito?
He's the main dog right here in the house.
Okay.
Okay, so, what do you want to ask me? Let's give me some history, man.
History. In the history of the heavyweight division, where do you place Vladimir Klitschko and Vitali Klitschko? Top 5, top 4, top 3?
Top 8.
Who are you top 8 heavyweights?
Top 8, Ali, Holmes, Jack Johnson, Joe Lewis, Evander Holyfield,
Marciano.
Rocky Marciano, okay? And then the Klitschko brothers. Could they beat Marciano? Yeah, way too big for Marciano. But if
could
The
they
Rock
be,
hit him...
Could they be...
No drop to them with those legends. Klitschko's fighting in a time where the heavyweight division sucks.
Well, that yeah, but yeah, I tell you
legends.
What.
The only last one that Klitschko fought who was, like, deserves to be a legend was fucking Lennox. And Lennox beat the shit out of him. And there's all, like, Char and all these guys that... They're fucking nobodies. The division sucks dick.
Okay, you heard that from the owner of the gym.
But, you're not going to argue with him?
I can't say much.
It's sucked in fucking 15 years. Since the 90s, it's terrible.
But Justin, what was it like for you to be back on HBO? A lot of people were excited to see you work in the corner. What? I was getting messages on the internet. Why? Because they know you? Because they like you?
On television. They said Justin Fortune in the corner.
Right, man.
And you kept telling him, put your effing hands up. What are you effing stupid?
Well, what is he?
When he steps back, turn the left hook, you cut. That's what you said. Yeah, when he steps in.
But it worked. It worked. You got whatever you told him.
No, it didn't work. And, you know, I thought it was a gift. I thought we were giving a gift. And, you know, I thought the kid came in 20. It was 172 when he fought us, which was a joke. And then fucking... You can't keep someone like... You can't keep someone like... Zinzerik out for a year and a half.
Why let him fight?
Oh, this is the one we keep hearing so much about?
Huh?
This is the one we keep hearing
Hello.
So much about?
Hello.
What? Hi.
Why let him fight? Because how much
you
going to
just been on the computer?
What are you going to do? HBO had no one else to put on there. Golovkin knocked his guy out in 5 rounds. Had Zinzerik not fought.
What do you think of Gennady Golovkin?
Don't trust him just because he's English.
The real deal?
Oh yeah. Listen, that middleweight division now. Pirov, Golovkin.
You're a real friend.
Fucking, and then you got Gil up there as well.
Because you can't get laid now.
It's an exciting division, I think.
But Justin, let's be honest.
I can't get.
If the opponent would have came in against the Zinzerik at the same weight class, not 25 pounds over, it would be a different fight.
Different fight altogether. I thought we got a gift anyway. It's not like he's a puncher. We can go in there and maul his way in and get some good shots because they're heavy-handed. Zinzerik's a boxer. If you keep a boxer out for a year and a half, that's what happens. You know, it's not the kid's fault. The last fight was Martinez, fucking a year and a half ago. You can't do that. So, you know, they'll fight him again in 3 months and there'll be a different Zinzerik again. He'll be with me for 2 months instead of 2.5 weeks.
I remember, I was here at the gym, I saw him train.
It all makes a difference, and then, you know, getting a win and putting back in for a title shot.
But how was your road trip, though? Did you have a good time, though, in New York?
It was good. I mean, Polano flew along with those guys. They're good guys. It was good fun. It was nice to be back on HBO and do all this stuff.
Next time you gotta take Macca Foley with you.
I don't work the corners in the gym anymore. I'm done.
He was gone to Maine and we would never see him again.
The main deer, yeah, they used to call me that.
How about this? Gennady Golovkin against Travis Jr. Who wins?
We're just talking about it. We don't understand that he is.
Come on, this guy can really fucking crack. He's a smart fighter.
From what I hear, it's the Golovkin.
He's 30 years old.
Chirog against Travis Jr. Golovkin, any other 60 pounders against Jr.
What about Martinez?
What about Martinez, Travis Jr.?
For fun, Martinez outboxed Chavez Jr. I think he wins. I don't think he stops him because Chavez Jr.'s got a good chin. And he's a fucking big guy.
I've heard that from all the big boxing stars. Just told me you just said.
Yeah.
That Chavez has a good chin.
I think Martinez outmaneuvers him, outboxes him. And then you have to see if it goes to a points decision, who's going to get the decision.